Visit our fabulous sponsor, Ka Gold Jewelry, link in the description below. Hello, fabulous Leo. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of April 2019, looking at life and love. I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here. What an amazing month it is. We do have one of the more fortunate days of the year. And the great thing is that fire signs are an intricate part of this, meaning that what is so good this month is going to be that much more available to you. You add to this a second rare full moon in the same part of the sky, what some people call a blue moon. Well, we've got a lot to talk about here. So let's start with early in the month. That is when we are going to have a new moon. This new moon is happening in fellow fire sign Aries, and it will be speaking in supreme harmony with Jupiter, but also speaking in conversations of tension with Saturn and with Pluto. Now, you look at this, right? Yes, on the surface, if you know a little bit about astro symbolism, you can see that this would represent a time where it feels like there's some pressure, possibly external, some deep desire to create meaningful change. And with this new moon happening in a part of the sky that has to do with your place in the world. Now that could be a literal place, as if we're talking about immigration, citizenship, or long distance travel, but it can also be related to your figurative place in the world. Having a vision of what it is that you hope to do and putting plans into place that you hope will come to fruition, your philosophical understanding of your place in the world, even higher education, legal matters are covered here as well. Well, it can look like there is a lot of possibility here for a great turn to take place for you. However, it is going to require you to move beyond some of your own fears, and some of what is most promising this month is probably going to come about by necessity, meaning that there may be a situation that feels a little bit challenging in the early part of the month that is part of what ultimately will give way to truly fortunate turns. And that is because we are going to have a beautiful connection between the sun in the same part of the sky that the new moon is in, and Jupiter. This is happening right around the 14th of the month. And so it is ultimately this new moon that is going to ensure that you don't sit on your laurels, as they say, right? That you don't get too lazy, that you actually ensure that you're using the energy in some way to move yourself in a direction that can unleash some of these larger blessings for you. In some way, you are going to find yourself on a bigger stage than you have known before. Now, this could come down to something like a publishing deal for some people, or a big contract that reveals itself to you in the middle of the month. And if so, it looks like it has the real potential to help you to grow that much more. However, for others, this can be that sense of what needs to be done, the sacrifice, that sense of maybe needing to turn things around because they don't seem to be going the way that you want in the early part of the month, that lends itself to the big breakthrough in the middle of the month. So that energy in the early part of the month with that new moon, use it well. Whether it is that you're trying to make a fresh start in your life, utilizing these different areas that I mentioned, or whether it is that you are coming to a different understanding of yourself and how you understand the world around you, regardless of where it is and how it is that your journey unfolds, chances are it will start with some difficult questions, maybe even some pressure, an awareness of time, an awareness of responsibilities that may feel rather large. But it is as we get to the middle of the month that you're able to transform the energy and unleash bigger blessings than you are anticipating, especially on the onset of the month. Now, as we move later into the month, right around the 19th, we are going to have a full moon. This full moon is special for a few reasons, and it is because it's a blue moon. So if you think back to last month, I mentioned that there was a full moon right around the equinox, right around March 21st. And full moons tend to bring with them completion and closure and culmination. But that full moon was happening at the very beginning of its month, which meant that with that sense of closure came a beginning that probably felt rather exciting. Well, now This full moon, although in the same part of the sky, is happening at the very end of its respective sign, which means this is a sense of true closure. This is a particularly emotional and perhaps intense sense of culmination that is going to take place now. This is a part of the sky that has to do with a few different things. Contracts and agreements are covered here. Learning new skills. So as opposed to, you know, the really big picture philosophical learning, it has to do with the little things you learn or the, you know, the day classes you may take, the book signings you may go to, the workshops that you may participate in. It also has to do with your relationship with your siblings, cousins, and neighbors. As I look at this, there may be some heightened desire to have a learning journey come full circle for you, or to manifest it, to make it real for you. It can also be a time that is particularly emotional around a matter having to do with a sibling, cousin, or neighbor. Now, even though this energy in some ways will hearken to what was happening a month earlier, the fact that this particular full moon is speaking with Jupiter in harmony, that does suggest that things can go in a favorable direction. But at the same time, it is standing across the sky from Uranus. And so there's this sense, very likely, of a matter coming up very much by surprise, and you needing to find adjustment, you needing to find your balance within it. It can be information, it can be a sense of some truth that you hadn't considered before. Remember, the last full moon we had, late last month, was during a particularly confusing Mercury retrograde. Well, by the time we get to this full moon, Mercury will be out of shadow. The whole Mercury retrograde season will be over. And this is going to allow you not only to ensure that you're seeing things more clearly now, but also that you are seeking truth as you strive to understand a particular moment. If there is an important conversation, negotiation that needs to happen, try not to do it too close to this particular full moon, because things could go in all kinds of directions that you hadn't anticipated. However, it could be that there is nonetheless an important conversation that happens, but if it needs to, allow it to come by surprise. If you're starting this month knowing that there is a difficult conversation you need to have, I would encourage you to do it right at the middle of the month before we get too close to that full moon, because you've got all this wonderful, very fortunate energy that is working with you as part of moving yourself forward. Where it comes to matters of love this month, Venus is going to, right around the days of this full moon at that, move into fellow fire sign Aries. This makes it so that this Venusian energy is that much easier for you to access, for you to be in touch with. I happen to love this energy for you. I think that it is going to be love in some key ways that starts to open up worlds to you and open up new perspectives. If you are open to meeting someone new, it is, as we move later into the month, that there's a sense of an international interest, if you will, or somebody who looks at the world, understands the world very differently than you do. Now, this can actually be part of a building of the blessings that start to be realized in the middle of the month. However, it is under the light of the full moon that Venus will change signs, move into a super compatible position for you, and you'll be able to use this in order to be more open to new types of experiences and to meet new types of people that you haven't before. And for those of you who are getting to know somebody, you know, this is going to set up a very interesting energy. I do feel like in the early part of the month, we've got Venus moving through a part of the sky that has to do with vulnerability and understanding what's just behind the surface. And so there's a sense of you wanting to know this person more deeply, especially if this is someone that you're just dating, or maybe becoming aware of where it is that there might be some trust issues there for you with truly allowing yourself to be known. But by the time we get later into the month, by the time we get to the 20th and Venus moves into fellow fire sign Aries, love starts to feel more light. It starts to feel more fun. And this is going to allow the two of you to enjoy that many more new experiences together without necessarily feeling as if everything has to be so consequential. For those of you who are in an established bond, well, it is in the first 3 weeks of the month with Venus moving through the part of the sky that has to do with a few things, but it includes your spouse's income. Well, that can bring a boost if you will, where it comes to what is happening financially with your partner, and that in turn can bring greater blessings into your life. But by the time we get you to the 20th and Venus changes signs, moving into fellow fire sign Aries, well, it becomes that love starts to feel more like an adventure, and the two of you start planning the next fun thing that you could move towards. What I love about this month for you, well, look, there's a lot here, but I love that connection between the Sun and Jupiter right in the middle of the month. The magic day is the 14th, give or take 2 days on either side. When you look at the power of this energy and the power of this moment, there's a sense of expansion, there's a sense of hope, there's a sense of possibility, and even magic as well. Remember, the Sun is your ruling luminary, which means that what happens with the Sun in the sky is that much more important for you. Well, when the Sun speaks with Jupiter in a trine, a conversation of supreme harmony, it can feel as if who you are and how it is that you can move your life in a positive direction, well, it's that much easier, and it's that much more supported by a loving and wise universe. Well, thank you so much for watching. You can get a video like this every week by logging on to nadiashaw.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded, exclusive video scopes every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy.